Welcome to Caseware Quick Vids. This video demonstrates the basic user interface areas in Caseware Financials. This video will cover two important areas. First, we will look at the Document Manager interface, where you will access the Financials template. And second, we will look at the Financial Statements interface, where you will modify your statements. This demonstration will use Financials IFRS. Please note that there are slight differences between the various financials products. When using Caseware Financials in a client file, opening the client file would bring you to the Document Manager. The Document Manager gives you access to all of the CaseView documents that you will use to complete your file. Accessing a financials document is as simple as opening a folder and double-clicking the document that you want to open. The most important folders for financials are Financial Reports and Template Setup and Control Documents, which contains various subfolders. Note that your administrator may have changed the names or the order of the folders and documents you see here. As a user, you should not use the Template Setup and Control Documents. Instead, only template authors should access and make changes within these documents. To become familiar with the interface, open the Financial Statements document under Financial Reports. Do this by double-clicking its name. The financial statements will generate automatically, which could take a few minutes depending on your computer's resources. Once all of the financial statements are generated, you will see the Financial Statements interface along with the CaseView menu. It is often not necessary to use the CaseView menu for anything other than page setup, printing, and print preview, which are all accessible from the File menu. In the Financial Statements interface, you are able to modify your statements using the abundance of tools and options offered by Caseware Financials. Tools and options for modification are available in ribbon format and in right-click menus. We'll look at the ribbon first. You can navigate through each section of the ribbon to see the many options that are available. Hover over an icon to view a tooltip that acts as a quick reference. The ribbon functionality is dynamic and context sensitive. It provides you with all available modification options based on your cursor's location. For instance, right now I am in my cover page, so I have a cover page ribbon. Pay close attention as I go to and click within my statement of financial position. There is now a specific ribbon for the area. Clicking within the Statement of Financial Position ribbon, you will see that the options applicable to my cursor's location have been enabled. The ribbon is displayed by default in the financial statements. However, you can choose to minimize it if you would like more viewing room. Click the Minimize Ribbon button. To the right of this button, there are various icons that will always display in the ribbon. Here you have the Home button, which returns you to the Document Manager, the Bookmarks button, which displays the different statement areas and allows for quick navigation, the Activation button, where you can enter an activation code for licensed content, the Knowledge Library folder button, where you can select a folder for your knowledge library, the About button, which contains the information about the financials version in use, and finally, there is a search tool where you can search through the online help topics to find assistance. Now, with an understanding of the general ribbon functionality, we will look at the right-click context menus. The right-click context menus display context-sensitive formatting options, all of which are available in the ribbon itself. However, right-click menus offer quick, convenient access to features. Clicking in a header, you can see the options that are available. In a different area of my statement, for instance a row, alternate options become available. For more information on the options in the right-click menus, refer to the online help. This has only been a quick summary of the user interface. As you can tell, the Caseware Financials interface is easy to navigate through and help is always a click away. This concludes the quick vid on navigating the user interface. For additional resources, including documentation and online help, see the related links in the description. Thank you for watching Caseware Quick Vids.